my friends. Today's art journal is all about my favorite spooky season shows. They don't all fit in the horror genre, but they definitely give me those dead leaves blowing down an empty street on a moonlit October night type of feelings. You know the ones I mean. First up is Penny Dreadful. I've only watched the first season, but this show has everything. Werewolves, witches, Frankenstein and his monster, Oscar Wilde's Dorian Gray. It also touches on mental illness, or rather how women were perceived to have mental illness when they failed to comply to societal expectations. Remember kids, the real monster is the patriarchy. Is Salem, because what's more Halloween-y than a group of witchy women railing against the puritanical patriarchy? One of my most favorite shows of all time, and that is Twin Peaks. It is a murder mystery with quirky characters for days, not to mention all the airtime given those quintessential roadside diner staples, pie and damn fine coffee. Plus, the rural mountain setting makes it a perfect autumn show. Is Hemlock Grove. Think vampires versus werewolves versus a shady medical laboratory. Season 1 actually took place during Halloween, and to me is the only season worth watching. Netflix actually suggested this show to me because I watched Twin Peaks. It's nothing like Twin Peaks, it's nothing like David Lynch, except in the fact that sometimes it makes absolutely zero sense. Don't get me wrong, I love me some David Lynch, but sometimes you need a map to follow his plots. Last but not least is The Haunting of Hill House, which Netflix did really well, and it's making me really excited for The Haunting of Bly Manor that came out this month. Initially, I was pretty hesitant to watch another adaptation of Shirley Jackson's novel, but I was actually pleasantly surprised at this version. There are some jump scares, if that interests you, but I find that the overall impending dread and character development more than make up for it.